Hello guys, welcome to an exciting episode of our effects series in CorelDraw. In this video, I'll be showing you how you can remove background from your subjects, from your images in CorelDraw. Yes, in CorelDraw. So without having to waste most of your time, let's get started. I would go over to my CorelDraw. I have mine open, so if you don't have yours open, kindly do so, so we'll get along together. So the first thing I need to do is I'll go to File, I click on New, and I'm just going to set my primary color mode to RGB, the width set to 4, the height set to 5. Resolution always stays at 300, right? And I'm just going to click OK, just like this, right? So right inside here, we don't have to do anything like clicking on this rectangle tool. So the first thing you need to do is you go over to Tools, then you go to Option, then you click on CorelDraw, right? I'm using the CorelDraw 2021. So if you need this version of CorelDraw, please kindly click the link in the description of this video that takes you to where you can download this CorelDraw version, right? Now I'm going to click on CorelDraw, and when this section actually pops up, I go to Edit, click on Edit, and the first thing we're doing here is checkmark this, double click to edit bitmap in Corel Photo Paint. So when you are doing your installation, guys, make sure you install Corel Photo Paint, right? Very important. So I'll click OK. I haven't checked this. I click OK, right? So next thing I would like to do is I'll go over to where I have my resource file. The resource file I use for this video is in the description of this video. So do well to click on the link that takes you to where you can download the resource file. So what I would do is I'll just go over to where I have my resource file. Yeah, and I'm just going to drag this beautiful model inside of CorelDraw just like this, right? So I'm going to zoom out, and I'm just going to make this smaller, make it smaller so it fits inside of the page that I want it to be. So while it's here like this, because of the settings that we just did, right, I will double click on the image. If you don't do that setting, if you double click on it, it's not going to work, right? So what I'll do is I'll double click on the image. So next thing we need to do is click on image and click on cutout lab, right? Good. So whilst we are inside cutout lab, we have various functions. We'll get through most of these things. If you want to zoom in and out of your image, you use your scroll wheel, or you use the plus to come outside, you use the minus and you zoom out like this. But let's get straight into removing the background we have on this image. I would want to reduce the size of my brush, which is the nib size here. So I'll just reduce it. I think this is too small. Increase it, right? Or hold down shift while you drag out like this to increase the size. So having done this, what you just do is, let me make it smaller. I'm holding down shift and I'm scrolling down like this. So I'll start from this point and I'll just nibble around the head like this. And I'm going to brush gently around the edges like this, right? So I'm going to scroll down again with, so I'm going to highlight the image like this. Just make sure you have a perfect selection of the image. Right, so I'm just going to highlight this way. I'm going to come over to this point and I'm going to start from this point too, and gradually I'm going to move up. Right, I'm going to move up gradually, and I'm gonna scroll up again, scroll up to this point, and I'm going to move up again. So I'll just finish it up by highlighting these areas, and when you make a mistake, Ctrl Z, make sure you don't get into the hair, and I think somewhere around here is good. So having done this, I'll click on the minus, so I'll zoom out completely. That's too far, let me come close, right? So next thing I like to do is I like to use the fill inside tool. So I'll just click on, let me zoom out to see what I'm doing clearly. So I'll just use the fill inside tool and just select the inside areas. So what I'm done with that, next thing I'll do is I'll just click on preview. Let's see the magic CorelDraw has created for us, right? So as you can see how, let me zoom close and move with my hand tool. You can see how CorelDraw has removed the background, and you can see how the hair strand is perfectly standing and everything is nice, right? So if you have areas of imperfection like what I have here and you need to fix it, what you need to do is this first one is to add details and the second one is to remove details, right? So I'll click on the remove details and I will remove details along this part, right? Just so it is balanced up. I'm going to remove this so only I have here, right? And I'm going to add details to this part. Let me zoom close so we see what we're doing in real time, right? So I'm going to add details to this part like this and like this, like this. I'm just going to rub it in and rub it in until I have something perfect, just like this. So this is how you add in details to areas that have been removed, right? All right guys, so as you can see now, it is, we have our image nicely cut out for us. So what I can do with this is I'll just click OK. When I'm done, click OK, and when I'm done, I'll just click on what, finish editing, and when it brings up this prompt, just click yes. And when you're done with everything, just close the Corel Photo Paint and voila, this is your image in CorelDraw. So this is your let me bring this in. So this is the before, make this small. So this is the before and this is the after image. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial series. I'll see you in the next video of our effect series. Thank you.